PNN in the house, coming at you from the P. Stacks and Sawecki on assignment from Ski.
Our show's about to open, but before we do, we're gonna hit you with some rhymes to prove we're cool.
Did you just rhyme do with cool?
Yeah, but you gotta say it like cool.
So the L is silent.
Huh? Well, yeah, I guess. It's me, your boy, Stacks on deck, and Sawecki easy, about to come cause the wreck. We're white, so what? We love to rap. We don't wear a baggie, we shop at Baby Gap. A lot of people say I look like Eminem. I'm just a normal kid who films for PNN. Spitting this flow takes a lot of stamina. Yeah, we stay strapped, but with our cameras.
We're tight, we're white, we know how to fight. We like to play dirty, but we don't like to bite. We're tight, we're white, we know how to fight. We like to play dirty, but we don't like to bite. My name is Sawecki, and I like to run. About to show you how white boys get it done. It was between filming of this, and this is what I chose. Now I'm living big and got a whip on 20 foes. Not trying to be cocky or trying to brag. I like to wear J's, and I like to sag.
We're tight, we're white, we know how to fight. We like to play dirty, but we don't like to fight.
God, you screwed it up. I knew you would. You screwed it up.
You screwed it up.
I screwed up here. Don't mess around with our gangster flow.
Think this was tight?
Just watch our show.
Good day, Merrillville. I'm Ashley Witkowski, and this is The Friday Show. After that opening by Ian and Adam, I don't know if they'll become famous or infamous, but I guess we could put it on YouTube and see if it becomes a viral sensation. I guess at the very least, we can call their rapping style, well, different. Overall, though, I don't think Eminem has anything to worry about. Although it happened a week ago today, students are still buzzing about prom. From the grand march and the king and queen crownings to the high-intensity dancing and peculiar DJ at the Avalon, prom was a great success. Whether you missed out or want to relive those memories, PNN was there and covered all the major highlights.
I don't believe we were put together not to be together. And I don't believe there's anyone out there that can love me better. I don't believe that you know how much I'm missing your pretty smile. Of course we had our ups.
We're wondering how you got in considering you weren't at school today. Don't you have to be at school all day to get to the Grand March of the Prom?
I was there, I was just invisible.
When I sleep, yeah.
I've been told I look cute, so I don't know.
I was a little bit surprised. I wasn't even expecting to be on the prom court, so I was just a little surprised and happy.
Voted for me, and they thought that I would represent the school really well, and it was glad to have all my family and friends here to just support me, and I really appreciated it.
How sad were you to give up that crown?
I wasn't sad because Robin's a great girl, and I was glad she got the crown, so it was okay.
Here at PNN, we have given you the award for most school spirit in a prom dress.
just had to convince my mom to spend like $600.
Diamond, get it. Where'd you get that match?
Why bother? Jalen Bentley already won Best Dancer. Are you going to go ahead and try to outmatch him to prove that you should have gotten the title?
I could, but we'd have to change the yearbook thing. That's the only request I have. If I win, we change the print in the yearbook.
In the hood. What in the world is in that bag? What you got in that bag? A couple of cans of whoop. You did a good job of just eyeing me, spying me.
I got my swing.
My sister Mimi, she picked it out. We just walked up in the store and she seen it. And once I put it on, I just got it.
Coach Ski gave a fashion do's and don'ts. And Brandon is one of four guys that did one of the don'ts. Can you guess what one of the don'ts were?
Shoes.
And
then.
You win the prize. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my shirt. So sexy it hurts. And I'm too sexy for Milan. Too sexy for Milan. New York and Japan.
Well, my favorite color was pink, so we had to do pink this year.
I'm too sexy for your party, too sexy for your party. No way I'm disco dancing. I'm a model, you know what I mean.
Carving words and letters in your head. We're wondering, is that fad coming back or did your barber just mess up?
No, it's coming back. For the people who don't know my name, this is just like a symbol. They can understand it.
Keanu, give good haircuts.
It looks like everyone had a fantastic time, and if you want to keep these memories alive forever, remember all the highlights will be part of the senior video, which can be purchased at the end of the year. Of course, the end of the year is really now when you think of it. Imagine, after today, there are only 12 days of school left, and two of those days include finals. This year has really seemed to fly by. I can only imagine the seniors are done counting days and have moved on to counting down the hours. As they look forward toward their big graduation day at the Radisson, they still have a few other fun events planned, such as the senior drive around.
Hey MHS, I'm Bree Pope. As you might have noticed, there's been a serious lack of half days this year. This means big changes for the seniors, especially when the senior breakfast and drive around is concerned. Unlike last year, when the seniors got out at 9:30, this year they had to stick around until 1:30. Students and teachers alike have had to make big changes to the schedule for the senior breakfast and drive around.
Senior sponsor Mr. James Stamper had to create the whole schedule for the senior breakfast and drive around and found it difficult to find enough activities for the seniors to do for 6 hours.
You know, the thing is, every year we have seniors come in all dressed up, ready to go. That's their breakfast day. That's their day they see their senior video. They're all excited about it, and after 2 hours, 3 hours, usually it's gone. And I really love this new schedule. It gives seniors more time with each other on that day where it's, you know, it's a break away from classes, but we're together. It's a together day.
The seniors also have had to adapt to the new schedule. Seniors Patricia Millard and Maddie Colefield don't like the idea of no half days and think it's a bum deal this year.
The senior drive around and everything, I was so looking forward to it last year. I'm like, yeah, we get half day. I got to see all my best friends who are seniors leave and everything. And then this year, they're like, oh, you get to leave at what, 1:30? I might as well be here all day.
It stinks that we don't get half days because I've been going to Merrillville for my entire life. And all of a sudden this year, they changed like, oh, no half days. So now for my senior drive around, I'm stuck here.
So as we look forward to the end of the school year, one of my favorite things to do during the summer is to go to friends' open houses. Between the fried chicken, beef sandwiches, and graduation cakes, I leave each one feeling stuffed. For those of you partaking in all of those festivities, make sure to still get some exercise on the side to keep your body healthy. PNN and Key Club are teaming up to show how to maintain a heart-healthy lifestyle, and this segment will show how you can get involved.
Some of us believe that since we're young, we're completely healthy, right? No. In reality, some of us are far from it. So Heat Club is taking the initiative to start a fundraiser for the American Heart Association by selling these hearts to student body and helping to promote the care of heart health.
A few weeks ago, Mr. Krutz approached me about having the Key Club do a fundraiser for the American Heart Association, and we're super excited to help raise funds for such a wonderful charity. Our goal for this project is to not only raise funds for the American Heart Association, but also raise awareness among our students as to the signs and symptoms of a heart attack and or stroke.
It's very serious. It's something definitely, if there's a family history, or if there are any issues like obesity, cigarette smoking, high cholesterol, all of those types of warnings we're seeing it younger and younger.
All this week, MHS faculty will be selling paper hearts of any denomination for the American Heart Association. This fundraiser promotes good heart health and physical activity. Bad heart health could lead to a heart attack with symptoms of chest discomfort, pain in areas of neck, jaw, and arm, lightheadedness, and shortness of breath. Also, stroke, a blood clot to the brain, carries symptoms of numbness and weakness on one side of body or face, slurred speech, facial droop, and severe headaches.
Any student who's interested in selling paper hearts can come see me. The student or teacher who raises the most for the American Heart Association will be receiving a $50 gift certificate to the establishment of their choice. So stop by room A108 and pick up some hearts if you're interested.
With many different activities planned throughout the week, PNN is helping Key Club by hosting heart-healthy activities during the morning show with prizes such as Subway and Jamba Juice. So if these prizes sound interesting to you, then stay tuned to the morning announcements for your chance to help out with this great cause. Signing off for PNN, I'm DeVillo.
I know as the school year winds down, we start thinking of activities we want to do next year. As the announcements are filled with call-outs for sports or clubs at this time of year, some of you may be unfamiliar with certain club activities. One acronym for a club you may not know is LGBTQ. Has it piqued your interest? If so, watch this segment so you can learn more about it.
Hi, I'm Bree Poulsen. For the past 5 years, MHS has housed an LGBTQ support group. LGBTQ stands for lesbian, bisexual, gay, transgender, and questioning.
Because it deals extremely personal situations, there hasn't been a lot of information about this new club. But PNN wants to know what this group does and what does it mean to the people that they help.
The LGBTQ group is led by social worker intern Ms. Smith, who meets with the group on Thursdays to discuss their lifestyle, challenges they face, and anything else they need to discuss.
I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do for my internship. I went to my academic advisor and I said, I think I'd really like to do some sort of, you know, gay and lesbian advocacy or something of that nature. And she said, oh, there might be an opportunity for you at Merrillville High School.
I think it's hard for members of the LGBT community to kind of get together and just feel like they can talk about anything. So with our support group, it kind of provides a space for that to happen.
There's a lot of people who are scared to come out and like are afraid to talk about their sexuality.
We've had crazy discussions. We'll talk about anything. You know, what happened during the school day, what happened the previous night at home. We're just so open with each other, and that's what's probably the greatest thing about it.
There are so many reasons that an LGBTQ support group is important in high school. It's a community that is very widely misunderstood.
Me personally, I've learned that you can't let every little person put you down.
I think it's funny, like, that people sit there and waste their time to try and put us down when at the end of the day we're still going to be here no matter what.
Led by Ms. Smith, the LGBTQ group will continue to support its members. Remember, MHS, let's be mature about this and respect people's right to privacy and the right to love whoever they love. Signing off at PNN, I'm Bree Popus.
As you walk through the hallways recently, you may have noticed certain students carrying something to their classes. No, I'm not talking about book bags or even cell phones, but small parcels of flour. Those who have partaken in this ritual know it is that time of year when students learn simulated parenting skills. Although they are not in class, two of our staff members decided to see what type of experiences they could have taking care of their own flower baby.
Usually, at this time every year, the child development classes start carrying around their flower babies around the school.
I see him carrying around these bags of flour and I can't help but wonder, how hard is it to take care of these bags of white powder?
To find out, me and Max put ourselves to the test to see just how hard it would be to cherish, cater, and love our very own flower baby.
We bought the flour and left to go to Max's house.
Dude, why are you talking to it? It's a bag of flour. It's not gonna respond.
It doesn't matter if it talks back. It's the thought that counts.
We showed the baby its new home and started taking care of it.
First, we introduced it to my dog.
Next, we taught the baby how to use the toilet.
Okay. Tyler! He went potty for the first time!
Oh, sweet dude, thanks.
Then our baby got hungry, so I got him some food.
Max, really dude, I think you're taking this flower baby thing a little bit too seriously.
How dare you? This isn't just some bag of flour, this is our child, and you need to love him.
Max, you're trying to make a bag of flour eat baby food. Baby food!
I'm done with this. You're a horrible father.
Are you mad at me?
I'm not mad. I'm just disappointed.
Finally, Max put that stupid thing in bed for a nap.
Aw, you're such a nice baby.
And you're such a nice parent.
What?!
That Tyler fellow is a horrible parent, but you're awesome.
Nightmare on Elm Street tonight.
Sweet! Yeah, you're right.
Well, then do it. You need to demand some respect around here.
Hey, Max. My mom has foot surgery tonight, and I cannot watch the baby, so I'm gonna be on my way to my mom's foot surgery, and you can take care of Flower.
Man, I couldn't wait to get out of there. Max is such a weirdo.
Oh, Flower baby, you know everything.
Honey, I'm home.
Where have you been?
My mom's thing, you know, my mom, she had that thing, the foot. And I had to be there and stuff, and you know,
What's this? A movie ticket? You have time to go to the movies, but not spend time with your child?
It's not a child, it's a bag of flour. Here, I'll prove it.
Hey, hey, what are you doing? Put me down.
Tyler, how could you?
Calm down, it's flour, it's dead. But there's a huge mess, so you should clean it up. But what are we gonna do with all this flour? Yeah, flour babies, very difficult, but cookies, very good.
Flour baby.
I don't see either Tyler or Max getting any babysitting jobs in the near future. Anyway, you all know how we here at PNN love our contests. After it became an event in the Dylan competitions with Matt and Melissa, we decided to see who in our class was best at We Karaoke, and we definitely found a few surprises.
Ever since Matt and Melissa faced Dylan in karaoke during their 7 stage challenges, the PNN staff began begging Ski to bring his karaoke machine for a good old karaoke match amongst the staff members. Hesitant to agree, at first, Ski accepted under one condition: the loser buys pizza for the entire class. Each contestant would play the game on level hard for one song of their choice. The staff had different opinions on who they thought would win and lose the competition.
I definitely think that Dylan is going to lose. He is by far the worst singer. I know he beat me by like 1 percentage point or whatever, but that's not going to happen again.
As far as the bottom of the barrel, two people come to mind. It's either going to be Dylan or it's going to be Mr. Past. No one has ever heard Mr. Past sing, and I think it's for a reason.
We kicked off the game with I Kissed a Girl by Katy Perry, which would have been a great song for someone other than Tyler.
It's not what I'm used to, just wanna try you on.
He scored 59% and set the bar for scores to beat. One after another, the PNN staff members had their chance to sing their heart out. And there were some surprising scores in there, including Melissa, picked as one of the people to win, scoring a 66% on her song, This Love by Maroon 5.
Oh, this love has taken its toll on me. She said goodbye too many times before.
Coach Pass picked to lose the entire thing, even beat Melissa by 1%.
Man on the moon, if you believe, there's nothing up his sleeve.
Great.
I beat Melissa. I beat Melissa.
Dylan, also picked to lose, did I Ran by Flock of Seagulls and scored 50%, putting him safely in the middle. Next up was Ian. He sang I'm Yours by Jason Mraz. A high song for someone with a deep voice, but he sang and sang badly. Scoring a mere 19%, putting Ian at the bottom of the scoreboard. Pauline shocked everyone with her impressive version of You Found Me by The Fray.
Surrounded, why'd you have to wait?
Scoring a 79%, allowing her to take the lead. Next was Mr. Soselski, as he did MJ's Ben.
Ben, the two of us need to look no more. We both found what we were looking for.
Scoring 81% and allowing him to take the top spot in the contest.
You know, it's better than 19%. That's all I was hoping for, so yeah.
Ian kept hoping someone would beat his low score, but it turns out that he would have to pay up for this terrible singing and buy the class pizza.
So Mr. C chose the worst singer in the class to deliver a rapping segment to open the show. He definitely has a warped sense of humor. Speaking of contests, we want to congratulate Lauren Tillman for winning a $10 Barnes & Noble's gift card in the poetry contest we helped sponsor with the Media Center. Great job, Lauren. You can pick your prize up in the Freshman Media Center. That is our show for today. Enjoy your weekend, and remember, with only 12 days left, finals are right around the corner. As we leave you today, we'll show you clips of each of our staff members taking a turn in the Wee Karaoke competition. This way, you'll get to see how bad we all are at this singing thing. Signing off for PNN, I'm Ashley Witkowski.
In the two of us need to look no more. We both found what we were looking for.
All alone, smoking his last cigarette. I said, where you been? He said, ask anything. Close my eyes and the flashback starts. I'm standing there.
You're vain, you're games, you're insecure. You love me, you like her. You make me laugh, you make me cry. But still I know which side to buy.
But I got tired of waiting, wondering if you were ever coming around.
And I have no choice, cause I won't say goodbye anymore. I know they're watching.
No.
They're watching.
Don't win.
All the commotion.
You're
the kitty like play.
Where were you, just an insecure? You found me lying on the floor.
Andy Kaufman in the wrestling match.
Oh, right here, buddy.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
She said goodbye too many times before. Her heart is breaking in front of me, and I have no choice.
I've been calling for years and years and years and years, and you never left me no messages.
Your protein pills and put your helmet on. Ground control to Major Tom.
Red us? Ow! But not on my wood. You understood. Love so new.
Love hurts. But sometimes it hurts. It feels like I'm a lie.
I've been way too time checking my tongue in the mirror, bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer.